Good morning, students. Let's continue with our topic, literary terms. And today I'm going to discuss with you the term symbol. The word symbol is derived from the Greek verb symbolein, which means to put together, and the related noun symbolon, meaning mark, token, or sign. So the term in literary usage refers to a manner of representation in which what is shown means something more or something else. It can be a sign, a shape, or object that is used to represent something else. Now, what's the definition of a symbol? A symbol is a setting, object, character, or event that carries more than the literal meaning and therefore represents something significant to understanding the meaning of a work of literature. In other words, we can say that symbols always have a literal meaning and a figurative meaning, means a concrete meaning and an abstract meaning, the hidden meaning. To develop symbolism in his work, a writer or a poet utilizes other figures of speech like metaphors, similes, and allegory as tools. Now I'll give you an example from literature. As You Like It is a play by William Shakespeare. And I am just reading these famous lines of Shakespeare from this play because they have symbolic value. Okay. So these lines are like this: all the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts. Now these lines are symbolic of the fact that men and women in the course of their lives perform different roles. We are like players. We are performing different roles, different characters. And a stage here symbolizes the world. This world is like a stage. Okay, so the stage is a symbol of the world. It here symbolizes the world. And players is a symbol for human beings. We human beings are players, and this world is like a stage. Then we have conventional or public symbols and private symbols. Conventional or public symbols have a previously agreed upon meaning. Means we all know the meaning of those particular symbols. They are public. We know they are like traditional symbols. So I am just giving you a few examples of these conventional symbols. Like for example, if we take different colors, if we take the color red, red color symbolizes blood. It also symbolizes passion or love, emotion. It also symbolizes danger or something daring. And we all know that this color is associated with all these, we can say, objects or emotions or feelings. Then like black. Black color symbolizes passivity. It also symbolizes death and even evil. White color symbolizes innocence, purity, and light. Green is the color of fertility. It's a color of hope, of growth, of new life. So we all know, and these are the conventional symbols. Means they are the traditional symbols if a person... Then we have private or personal symbols, which poet or author develop themselves. Though they use pre-existing symbols, but generate a different meaning or significance, and that makes the difference. That makes a difference between a conventional symbol or a public symbol and private or personal symbols. Now, symbolism is a rhetorical device. It allows writers to expose further truths as they pertain to their message or theme. It also allows them to embrace the beauty or the struggles of life in thoughtful and unique ways. So symbolism helps a writer. Symbolism is actually necessary for a poet or an author who wants to say more than what meets the ear, want to suggest something beyond the expressed meaning. Okay, he wants to say something hidden, he wants to express something which remains hidden through the help of these symbols. For this, I'll just give you an example here. When William Blake wanted to give an idea of the ferocity of nature or about the ferocity of the tiger, he used the image of the bright burning tiger. This doesn't mean that he was actually burning. The sense of mystery and expansiveness, the feelings of richness and complexity, a symbol may communicate, and it cannot be communicated ordinarily by other means. So when William Blake says bright burning tiger, this doesn't mean that he was actually on flames, but he was so ferocious, the tiger, he wants to symbolize the ferocity of nature, the ferocity of that tiger, that how ferocious he was. Symbols make the language rich and expressive, and concepts which by their very nature are inexpressible, they can be conveyed in this way in a better manner. So symbolism is arguably one of the strongest literary devices writers have. And when used properly, it can enhance a piece of writing and provide further insight to the reader. Much can be said behind while hiding behind the symbols that stream from nature and everyday life. So this is what a symbol is. What's the meaning of this term symbol, from where it originated? What's the definition of symbol? Then the types of symbols. We have conventional or public symbols, and we have private or personal symbols. Then why they are important? What is their use? All this we have discussed today, and tomorrow we'll do the next literary term, short story. Thank you.